Good morning, guys. Welcome back to another vlog. I'm back from Coachella. Yesterday I did the day off vlogging because I was just having a nice reset day, and I kind of wish I would have vlogged it because it was very nice. I made cabbage soup. I made some floral arrangements. I went to Trader Joe's. I went to Goodwill and I did some shopping. I wanted to get some stuff just for like tabletop for like my dinner parties, you know, the huge. And I hit the jackpot. I got so much stuff. I did like a TikTok vlog. You guys wanna go see it. And I'm really excited. So got all of that stuff. And I'm slowly but surely creating my collection in my tabletop closet out there, which I haven't really shown you guys yet because it is very messy. So not gonna do that yet. Today's Wednesday. It's a big day. So I'm about to go work out. I'm making my coffee right now. I'm doing weightlifting this morning, getting back into my routine. I'm home mainly for the next like month. I only have one trip, which is to Austin. So I'm really excited about that. That's not enough but coffee. Oh guys, also my Taylor crew from the bar came in. I got it in a double XL and it's literally a dress, but it's so soft. The quality of this definitely feels like lesser than ones that I've gotten in the past. Like, it feels lighter, which is fine because it's the time of year, but like I swear it's like a different blank. Like it's not as, I don't know, but it still is really soft and I'm not complaining. Shelby Sacco actually is in Dallas to record. We're gonna record a podcast swap this afternoon. I need to get a blowout this morning. Get ready. I have a lot of stuff around my house I need to do, like laundry. I've been content. Look at him, he's just so perfect. I got my new bedding. I ordered stuff from Bull & Branch. Not sponsored, ordered it myself. And then I just have a bunch of other random stuff that I need to get done, clean up a little bit, and record a solo before she comes over. I also have this new thing called SpeakPipe, where if y'all want to be on the show, you can call in, leave a voicemail at speakpipe.com/ILYSM, and then you guys can be on the podcast. Like crazy stories, advice, questions, whatever, things you want to add, like funny things. Like literally if you are sitting and listening to the podcast and you're like, oh my god, I want to say something, or if you're ever like, oh my god, I want to tell Kenzie this, or tell the girlies this, that's where you call. But I'm really excited because I came home to a Blue Land package. I love Blue Land. I've had them in the past and it is just the best thing ever as a homeowner. And also just having a new home, new to me. I am really honestly a clean freak. Like I'm cleaning up these counters 24/7. I just feel like it makes me want to be even more on it. A lot of cleaning products have really harmful chemicals in them and I don't love that. I feel like a lot of people start to think about this when they have kids. You know, I have dogs, so that's good enough for me. But seriously, like, it kind of freaks me out. But Blue Land, right here, I got the cleaning kit, the essentials. It comes with, like, four. It's amazing. They have tablets that have no harmful ingredients. So they believe that you can have it all, basically. They're effective, they're convenient, they're affordable. I also love that I can just fill this up with hot water, pour this in, and then just use this bottle. So it's obviously better for the environment. You can also save money and save space without the waste. I hate having a ton of one thing since moving in. I've decluttered my house so much. And to be able to use this, like reuse this, and this is what I'm storing, like only this, instead of having like a billion things that are piling up and whatever, I love this, especially if you're like an apartment apartment owner, whatever. You live in an apartment, okay? I got the Clean Essentials kit, which is amazing because I feel like I really don't need anything else. It came to my house. I have soap, there's a glass cleaner, and there's a bathroom cleaner. It's also so easy. All you have to do is fill this with warm water and then drop this tablet in and you're good to go. All you have to do is click my link below to get 15% off. Do that ASAP. They don't do sales apparently. So I will have that linked below. I recommend the Clean Essentials kit. Comes with multi-surface, the bathroom cleaner, the glass cleaner, and hand soap. Much better for you, much better for the environment. Cannot recommend enough. Also these like other cleaning things, they're just not good for you, not good for your skin, not good for anyone involved. So Blue Land, click my link down below. Okay, right, thanks again to Blue Land for sponsoring this video. Anyways, y'all, we're heading off to weightlifting. I'm gonna blow out. Oh my god, we have to talk later. I'm talking too much in this, but like I have some book updates for you guys and they are top notch. Like, oh my god, so good. First book that I would like to talk about, guys, I'm already back, is Things We Left Unfinished, I think. It had been all over everywhere, and I had gotten it on the Kindle Unlimited. I think it is a Kindle Unlimited book, or maybe I paid pay for it, like, a couple months ago. And then I just forgot to read it. Like, I read, like, the first few pages, and I wasn't into it. And then
I was like, okay, I'm gonna read this again. And then I saw other friends that were reading it who were like, oh my God, it's so good. So it made me like stick with it like a day, because it was just the very beginning that I wasn't into. But I'd already been back, and then, you know, my friends, they really helped me persevere. So I will say, that is how I ended up reading it. Like, if you are like me and you were, this beginning was slow, stick with it. It was so good. I don't know if I mentioned this in my last week in my life vlog. Maybe I did, but I literally, like, I was in between appointments and I was reading it during my appointments. I stayed in a parking lot, like, over where I'm passing to finish the book because I couldn't even wait the 10 minutes that it would take for me to drive home to then finish it at home. Like, I had to finish it, and I finished it in my car. That is how good it was. And then Abby Jimenez, I need her to hear her say it so I know that I'm pronouncing it right. And I, like, she's honestly, I think she is a favorite author because she's written 5 books now, 4 of which I've rated 5 stars, and this one I rated 4.5, and it's Yours Truly. It was the sequel to A Part of Your World. She has the Friend Zone series that I always talk about that sounds really cheesy and bad, right? But then you read all, like, you read them. I don't even know what got me to read them. I just, like, happened to pick them up from, like, the Kindle store, and they are so good. They talk about, like, heavier topics, but in a light, in a way that's, like, done well. I don't know, I don't know how to describe it. That series, I read all 3 of those books in 3 days, and I got Part of Your World, love that one. And then I read the sequel, and I also loved that one. I know that I've seen, like, at least one person be like, I didn't like it, and I think it's just because that person, like, doesn't like that kind of guy. I loved it, and I love her, and she is my favorite author, I think, at this point, because all of her books are just, like, she hasn't had a miss for me yet, and I'm really, really pumped about that. So I'm really sad that that book's over. I'm reading another Ellen Hildebrand book. I read Nantucket Nights before that, and that was good too. I'm kind of just, like, getting through all of her books because, like, I just want to be in Nantucket, or on Nantucket, or in Nantucket. I don't know, I forget. It's, like, such a, they get mad when you get it wrong, on Nantucket, because it's on an island. I don't know, I don't want to be canceled by my Nantucket folk, guys. I need them to like me. So, yeah, we'll see. Anyways, I like Disney to my eye too. So that's not good, but we're pushing through today, guys. Today, it's gonna be a good day. Guys, Shelby is here. I haven't vlogged pretty much all day since I got my blowout and worked out. We just recorded the best episodes ever.
They're so good.
So good. Coconut was, oh, there she is. She was snapping and I just woke her up. So I gotta go, but this looks so cute too. Snapping. Got all of our food. Oh my God, a Yelp girly. We're at R&D. Woo! Hi guys, sorry I didn't do the best job vlogging today, but it was a podcasting day, so it was just really all over the place. Also, the weather is weird, and I feel like it doesn't normally affect my hair, but my hair fell big time, which is fine because I restyled blowouts anyways. I got a PR package from Orkin, like pest control, and they sent me a citronella scented candle, which is amazing. And then all this like bug themed like kitchen stuff, so cute. I showed it in a TikTok, but I have a mini little toolkit here. I mean, like, so convenient. And I also am like, oh, I love obviously anything kitchen. Anyways, it's 8. Shelby just left my house, and like, she's the best. And we just had like the best time hanging out. I felt like we've like been friends forever. Love her, so sweet. And if you guys don't follow her, I'm sure all of you guys have seen her all over TikTok, like the Sad to Savage series. That's all her. Not even serious. It's like a bit. It's like a whole thing now. But she's just great, and I love her. So, anyways, I'm just gonna chill tonight for the rest of the night. My house feels like so cozy, guys. Like, it's just love. I need to move the chair. I made a little like impromptu set over here earlier. I'm just cleaning up now. We went to R&D, as you guys saw, for dinner. And that is it for my Wednesday. I can't believe it's already Wednesday, but I guess I didn't vlog on Monday, so whatever. Anyways, I feel like my blowout today, they were like really rough with my hair. And I'm like, did you like pull my hair out? Like, this never happened before. But I was like, oh my God, it was painful. And it looked good, but then it just fell, you know? Good morning, guys. It is the next day. Oh no, Coco. Please be quiet, I'm begging. One second, everyone.
later in the afternoon and I've just been working. But I finally unboxed my new bedding. I ordered from Bowl & Branch, not sponsored, ordered it myself. Also, my bedding or my bed frame, I think it's Overstock or Wayfair. I'll link it below. I had it in the last house. It's now in my guest room. And then I got a king size bed for my bedroom because I finally have a room where a king size can fit. But I still have a lot to do with the bed. Like, this room has been like such a mess. This is just so harsh, I feel like, right here. I really like my room being really neutral. I still have boxes there that I need to go through. I still have my whole garage that I have to go through and really set up the guest bedroom, even though there's really no room for anything besides a bed and the TV that's already there, but I need to like go through it. Anyways, I love this stuff. This got moved here and it's literally upside down and it's not the vibe for in here. I think it's gonna move. Also, this is custom by Mackenzie Jones and like those things got messed up in the move, which is heartbreaking. But honestly, I'm gonna keep this piece forever and probably put it in like my daughter's nursery in 15 years whenever I have kids. So anyways, I have that. And then also I had this idea because I had my frame TV, like the small one that I had in my master bedroom. The issue is that like I don't even know where the cord is, so I've got to find that, but I'm gonna have this installed in my bathroom. So I'm gonna have it installed right here, and this is a mess because I just threw everything from when I unpacked. Here's the issue. So in here, my grandma was at the store and she picked me up these containers from Walmart, and they're massive. They're like 10 by 20 by 6, which are so difficult to find online. They're from Walmart, the Home Edit collab, and they're not sold anymore. I can't find them anywhere. Actually, I'll try again today, but I need these. I need like 5 more of them so then I can like organize everything and then put like towels and whatever and have all the bathroom actually organized, because it's just not like, I still have boxes here and I don't do well with clutter, especially in my bathroom, but here I am. Anyways, the TV is gonna go right there and then we'll just like somehow hide it, the cord to there, whatever. And that way I can like sit in the tub and like watch a podcast or listen to music in here or whatever. And I really like that because I don't care about having a TV in my bedroom, but the bathroom will be better, especially for like getting ready to go out, like having a whole entire experience. I love that. So I'm doing that. Also, last minute, Dom is coming to town next week. Very short trip. Oh my God. Oh my God. What? I used the Tanologist Express Tan. It looks like fine on this arm, but this is so bad. So I have to figure that out. Anyways, you know, I've looked better in life, but whatever. I'm not feeling my best today. So anyways, I got a lot of work done. I also ordered, you know what, maybe you can set that up. I ordered, where did I put that? A tripod to like install on this wall. Oh, it's right here. And it looks like really confusing, but I'm gonna see if tomorrow the guy who installs my TV can install this, because then I can like set you guys up and have a vlog spot in my bathroom, because right now I don't, and you guys are sitting on light, which is very unsafe. So anyways, I've gotten a lot of work done today. It's just not been very exciting. I just ordered stuff to make like a new meal. I became a subscriber of ButcherBox. Like, I'm very heavily influenced in this vlog. I'm not working with them at all, but I wanted to get it because I'm really trying to eat more protein. I find that I feel like a billion times better when I'm eating more protein than when I'm cooking at home. And like, it really doesn't even matter what I'm cooking as long as I'm cooking at home and just feel better. Also, while we're in here, I was influenced by Maddie Mayo from OK Sis. She posted about Honey, I think. This is the Water Bomb, the Deep Hydration Body Mist. And then, what I think, I mean, they're both incredible, but like, what I love, it's this Honey Splash Solve. You put it on like after you shave in the shower, then you wash it off, and it like doesn't really fully get off because it's like really moisturizing. But it is like the most moisturizing thing ever, and I'm constantly looking to like get that glow and feel hydrated, and it's so good. So I will link it below. I'm always like looking for new like body products. I love Osea and I love Kipari. Those are like my tops, but I am obsessed. So anyways, little home update. I'm gonna keep you guys through. I need to do laundry and get some other work stuff done and just like brainstorm and get in bed. But I'm just feeling a little bit under the weather. So that is what's happening. But if you guys have any ideas, like I do feel like I need like a softer dresser. This rug, I love the actual, I don't love like the print as much, but it's ruggable and like I picked it out myself. So I love ruggable rugs because you can wash them in the easiest rugs ever. This is also my weighted blanket that I sleep with every night from Brooklinen. I also paid for this myself, not sponsored. But I love this thing. It's like a must have in any home. I need more and I need more colors. I wish I had a chocolate brown. Like if they had a chocolate brown of these, I would die for it. I do need to get lamps, and then I probably need to take something off of there and then do like two pieces on the wall, like here and there. Honestly, this room is just like not much of a priority. Also, I really do need to plant some flowers in there. We also need a landscaper to come in and get rid of that box. It's driving me insane out there, and it's just been sitting there for days. But my table and bench, I think, should be here in the next month from Pottery Barn. So that'll be great. I am hosting two things at this house in the next like week. So I'm gonna like rent a table and chairs. I was looking into that earlier. But I love that. I also put in an order for my blinds and my blinds and like curtain. No, I guess they're all blinds. Anyways, blinds for the entire house. So I'll finally have those. In the next, like, I think they said 6 weeks because they're all like custom. I'll do like a whole thing on them. They're gonna look really nice. But those are also coming. It's also storming today off and on, so the weather's just like really weird. But trying a new recipe tonight. Very excited. I just made this meal with the Butcher Box ground beef. It smells amazing. I'm gonna have an olipop. It's only 5:30, but I'm really not feeling the best. I think I just need to sleep. I don't know. But it was a productive day, so that's good. Gonna eat my food, watch One Tree Hill, read, and hopefully go to bed. Hi guys, happy Friday. I slept maybe 3 hours last night. There were really bad storms. And the dogs, their new thing, well, Fitz's new thing is that he's terrified of storms. Coco already hates it. She has to sleep in the crate. She's on crate rest. So I woke up, Fitz is on top of me. Coco's going crazy. I had, like, basically, long story short, 3 hours of sleep. Canceled my workout this morning because I was so tired. I just got my nails done, finally, and I'm actually about to head off to Best Buy really fast. I'm hoping to get my small frame TV hung up today and just get the rest of my to-do stuff. I did wake up and end up getting some stuff done, but guys, like last night, I feel like this week is a mess. My anxiety's already been so high, so to like not have any sleep too isn't really helping. But anyways, off to Best Buy we go. All right, no luck there. I think I just have to order it online. I don't know, this Connect box thing is confusing. Anyways, I'm gonna go to Target because I do need to get some other things. Oh, you know what, I think I have a call. I need to do returns. No, okay. I feel like that'll help me because I'll have things organized. You know what I mean? I'm just hoping for the best here. I have not been to Target in so long. I got a ton of stuff from Target. So most of it though, they put like one thing per bag. I don't know why. These containers I'm gonna try for my bathroom. I wanna try these on my bed and just see. This is for Sophie's birthday present. And then I just got some like bathroom stuff. I also got really cool chargers. I think they're in here. I saw these and I was like, I have to have them. They're so cute and they're gonna be great for Coastal Cowgirl, but also just like all summer long. Even, I mean, honestly, on a day to day, I love them. Great for hosting. I got more coffee and then I'm gonna try this Chobani flip thing. I love Chobani yogurt. And then I just got some of these, which you guys will see for my bathroom.
All right, guys, giving you a little Coco update. If you're new here, she had IVDD surgery a month ago. I woke up and her back legs were just paralyzed. It was very, very scary. She'd already been like medically treated for IVDD and she'd completely healed, something happened. Anyways, like her back, there's a scar where I'm covering it. You can probably see like it's shaved. She's just a mess because like I'm constantly bathing her like nonstop because she like, she can't, it's just like a whole thing. She can't go to the bathroom unassisted, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, we've been doing our exercises and she's going to physical therapy a week from today. And every time I do exercises, I freak out, like, cause she still can't walk and I just get so stressed. And then I watch videos, but I've seen a lot of videos where people's dogs still were not walking a month after surgery. Some are walking immediately and then they go to physical therapy and then it takes a couple months and they can walk. So Coco is literally going to physical therapy. I cannot make this up, but she's in good spirits. Like she has her personality. She's on trazodone a lot of the time. So she doesn't, she's still in crate rest right now. So she like has to
calm down. But I mean, even if she wasn't on Crit Rush, she can't really like move anyways. I mean, she can move, like she can, she just like drags her butt, if you know, obviously you know what I mean. Guys, this is what I mean. I'm just not alive today. So anyways, we did our exercises. Coco's gonna take her little afternoon nap. I'm gonna get on a call and start organizing my bathroom. It's gonna be beautiful, it really is. She's so tired after these exercises, like her eyes are slowly shutting. It's okay, girly, and she can't like go to the groomers. So, and I can't like fully give her a bath on my own. I need someone to help. So when someone comes over that can help, she's getting a bath because she's made a mess with her food today. All right, guys, I got this hat because Danielle had it when we were in Cabo, and so I asked her for the link, and I got one because I need it for like the pool, but I got it in a size large because I have a big head, and I feel like, I don't know, be honest with me, like, is it too big? But it's supposed to be like big and floppy. I don't know. I also think it's fine because it's like kind of supposed to be this way, but like, I don't know, I already got rid of the return stuff for Revolve anyway, so I don't really have an option. It's kind of bent right here. It's kind of like, I don't know, I can't tell. I really, really cannot tell. Please let me know. But also, it's supposed to be big. I feel like it's fine. And I can actually like pack it. Like that's the thing I like about it. It was definitely pricey, but I feel like I never buy hats like these because you can't pack them, and this you can pack however way, whichever way it is. Like this, I think. I don't know, let me know. I don't know. I'm embarrassed to share what this looks like because it looks insane right now. I just have boxes and just like my stuff laid out everywhere. I already showed you guys yesterday, I know, but just to give a little refresh, like I wanted more of these and Walmart is not selling them. Maybe they're selling them now and I should check again. I got instead like these boxes, which I haven't even tried, and they don't like fit all the way back. But I was thinking maybe like I just go and I like stack them that way. And then I just put the stuff that I don't use as much back there. Like whatever, I don't even need the extra cleaning because I'm replacing everything with Blue Land. So anyways, that stuff needs to go there. And there's like extra product, so much stuff. So I'm gonna set a timer and get this going. This is the before, be prepared to be shocked. Oh, I also got that, but we'll get to that in a second. Like this is the first time this is really gonna be clean. All right, and the after took me a little under an hour. I need to clean this Versace robe. My stuff's up there, and then I hung up another robe. My shower, I need to figure out. But this feels a lot better. The drawers are not super organized, but they do. I mean, they're like organized per like whatever it is that I'm using regularly. But like, you'll see what I mean. Like this is, it's still a mess, but it's like an organized mess, and I need to get containers and figure this out somehow. What I've decided, okay, so over here, this is still, I mean, it's a lot better than it was. That's like miscellaneous extra product from, what was that noise? From PR. This is hair stuff, and then I have cleaning stuff, I have my sheet mask here, and then this is self-tanning stuff, which I have so much of, and like, look at my hand, it looks way worse on camera, I will say. In person, it looks not as bad, but not good. Then I have like body products. I have refills of things that I use regularly. So like Divi, Real Techniques. I threw my makeup bag over here, which I need to go through because it's obviously like busting at the seams. And that's what I will just like move over every day. I have extra containers down there. And then just like travel bags and stuff. But it's definitely feeling like a lot better in here, I will say. I need to get a bath mat. This is just like a Brooklinen like towel mat. That is like donations and trash. It feels so much better in here. So eventually the TV will be there. It'll be like a frame TV. So it'll be like an art piece, but also a TV to watch when I'm getting ready. It's just gonna have the best vibe. I love it in here. I just love this house. But here we are, finished. So here are the pillows here. I need to get some more up front. I do like them. I need to cut the tags off. What I just like love Target Euro Shams. I used to have the best ones from them and they don't sell them anymore. But I like the different texture. I don't love that my bed is like stark white, but I can just like add more and more. And obviously I switch up bedding. But I do love the Pull & Branch bedding. Like sleeping on it for one night was incredible. I just wish I would have gotten like an oatmeal color maybe. But also, I don't know, I like the way it looks. I don't know. I'm a fan. Hi guys. Oh, there he is. I was literally, oh my God, you look so perfect. Look at him just staring at me and smiling. He's not smiling anymore. Camera shy. Anyways, okay, I just went outside trying to play fetch with Fitz and he had no interest in the ball. He just wanted to sit and stare at me. I got you a yard. You gotta run around or something. he goes through his periods. He needs a bath. But anyways, we're gonna do a little Q&A. I feel like I just like haven't been as like present. But I don't know what's going on. It's just my anxiety, you know? It sounds so annoying, but it is. So anyways, these Olipop root beers are my favorite drinks ever. Weird thing about me, I am not a soda girly, but I love root beer. And I know that's like everyone's least favorite soda, but for whatever reason, it's a soda that I love. So I'm gonna be answering some questions. I'm excited for next week to be like a full week at home because next week's vlog is gonna be so good. I'm hosting the Coastal Cowgirl dinner. Weather isn't looking great for next week, but I'm hoping that it's just Texas and it'll change. I have a shoot for the pink puff bag that all of you guys want. Oh my God, on this day 5 years ago, it's like my photo from Coachella, guys. Like, oh my God, if you guys are here for that, like please let me know. They had a photographer, I didn't take that myself. Anyways, wow. Dom is going back to Coachella this weekend. Like that is so crazy to me. Like there isn't a number that could make me be like, I could do that this week. There's no way. No way. Tonight I'm going to dinner with Taryn and Presley. We're going to Drake's and then I'm hoping we go to like Inwood or something. It'll probably be chill. And then tomorrow I'm going to Fort Worth, which I'm excited for. I think a weekend away from like social or whatever will like help me. I don't know how to describe it. Like, and it sounds stupid and I'm so grateful. Like, I'm not talking about like the job aspect. Like, that's not it. I just think sometimes if I'm like constantly filming or constantly like making content. Sometimes TikTok doesn't bother me because it's just like fun, whatever. But if I'm like constantly doing this, it's like always in the back of my head. And so I'm not like fully like relaxed or like it doesn't help my anxiety for whatever reason sometimes. So anyways, people asked, where did I get my Taylor Swift Eras Tour clear bag that I was posting on TikTok? It's from an Etsy shop on TikTok and I like pinned a comment of the shop that commented on it. Tarte gave those to us, so I didn't order it, but it's from an Etsy shop. If you go on my TikTok and you see the Eras Tour bag, it's on there. My phone service is not loading other than like things that are already on here. But I'll try to link it below too if I can find it. I tried to look and I couldn't find it, but they linked, like their profile was tagged. Place in Texas you haven't been to but want to visit? I would like to go to Marfa. I've never been to Marfa. I've never been to Houston. Isn't that crazy? I'm not like dying to go to Houston, but I've never been. I would love to go to the Houston Rodeo. I definitely want to do that next year. I say that every single year, but like next year, I really want to. I almost went on that VivRel trip, but I had my national show, so I didn't go. And then, I don't know. I would like want to spend more time in like the Hill Country, I think. Where should I take my parents to in Dallas? I would take them to either Honor Bar, R&D, or Bowen House, or Las Palmas for dinner. And then I would take them to a comedy show at 40 Weekend, which is right behind the Trader Joe's on Greenville, but it's a comedy show and they only have, I think it's just Friday, Saturday shows, but they're really funny and they're so good and it's like such a good thing to do with your parents. I would definitely recommend. Most versatile pair of cowboy boots you have, definitely my Annie boots from Tacova. I have them in Sequoia, which is just the brown color. I will link them. There's something in my eye. Also, by the way, the links to my last video got messed up. I do go through and link all of them. I'm so sorry guys. So I don't know what happened there. And they're gone. Like, I don't know what's going on. I keep trying to redo it and it won't save. So I'll link those now. Thoughts on dating apps lately. I've never actively been on, like I'm on apps, but I'm not like, I'll match people, but I never message back. Cause that's just like, sounds like the last thing I want to do, which I know is not the right perspective and I need to be doing it. But I really am just holding on to hope I meet someone in person. And I live in Texas, so I feel like I have a higher chance. And anyone who lives here is like, oh my God, whatever. You've not experienced dating in Los Angeles, so it's a completely different game. Dating in Texas is literally like chef's kiss, so much better. But, and just like meeting people in general. So I'm like really holding out hope that I meet someone in person. So we'll see. Oh, why are you moving to Snapchat? Okay, I did post this. You guys can add me on Snapchat, I can see the Texan. I don't know, I feel like, I don't know, I keep doing this, I keep moving from platform to platform, but I just want to be on everything, so I do have a Snapchat, and I'm probably going to be posting, like, daily, I don't actually know exactly what I'm going to be posting there, probably, like, daily vlogs or, like, stories that, like, Dom and I've done this before that, like, we wouldn't tell elsewhere. Every time I get a new platform that's, like, my smallest platform, I'm a lot more unhinged there, and I'll, like, say things that I wouldn't normally say because I'm, like, afraid, you know what I mean? What's on your TBR? I don't really have anything right now on my TBR, I don't think. Oh, I will read Emily Henry's new book. It's normally books that are coming out, but Lucy Score's book this year already came out. So did Abby Jimenez. yeah, I feel like I don't have anything right now. I'm just reading a lot of Ellen Hildebrand, honestly, because I want to be in Nantucket. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I love you guys so much. I'm going to get ready, have a good weekend, and let me be back next week with the best Week of My Life vlog you guys have ever seen. Love you guys, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.
I've been matching with people that, like, are literally, like, not that at all. Like, an actor or, like, someone in a creative space. And I've just been realizing that, like, I've been enjoying it so much more because I want to ultimately be with someone who loves their job as much as I love my job. Like, I think that that to me is actually my non-negotiable, right?
Yeah.
And I think that typically is the finance bro, like, I'm not making a generalization, but I kind of am, that, like, they might not be as, like, fulfilled. Maybe, like, they make a lot of money. But I want to be with someone who, like, maybe isn't, like, I don't know, who just genuinely loves what they do because you spend the majority of your life working.